How you doing, nieces and nephews? It's your old Uncle Ed back at you with another e-juice review. As you can tell from the clouds, we got something good in store. What I have for you today is Dr. Crimmys. I know I've threatened to do this review for a while. I just haven't gotten around to it. What I have for you today is root beer float with extra ice cream. The born-on date was 8/28, and today is 10/16, so it's had a nice long time to steep. As always, I got a 3 nicotine and 80 VG, 20 PG. Cost of the 120 ml bottle, as always, $30. Not bad. Let's go to the smell test. On the smell test, you're getting an ice cream smell with a faint root beer smell. Okay. Let's go with the flavor. Cloud Productions, Productions. Excellent, as always, and to be expected with Dr. Crimmy's e-juice. The flavor, you're getting the root beer, a good root beer. Probably along the lines of an A&W root beer, which I do like. I used to like it. They used to have a shop, one of their little restaurant thingies. Where's food and root beer? It's gone. It's gone. And on the back end, you're getting a creaminess note that I'm saying is the ice cream. Through the nose, it's nice and smooth. And you get that combination of root beer and a cream. It's good. I can't fault it at all. Zero throat hit. Let me read you the description off the website. This is a root beer float. If you try real hard, you can even taste the fizz. You really can taste the fizz. As weird as it may sound. The ice cream note comes, like if you put a scoop of vanilla ice cream in a mug and then you pour the root beer over, and you know how it like bubbles and you get that kind of foam. That's the predominant flavor that I get. It's not like strictly the ice cream, it's not strictly the root beer. It's that real bubbly foam that you get with a root beer float, which is very, very good. Very pleasing. Nice long finish in the mouth. I can't fault the juice whatsoever. But Dr. Crimmys has made a couple changes. If you saw my shipping codes and everything in my past Dr. Crimmy videos, that is no more. I'm going to back up a little bit and tell you a little something, or read a little something, that it's not a knock on the quality of the juice at all. But it's a change that they made that I personally am not too happy about. Important update as of 10/13/2014. Promotion for free shipping. The free shipping option will only be available for orders of $75 or more now. The free option will be applied using the code free ship in all caps in the coupon field without quotations and with capital letters. Processing time now is 1 to 4 business days. Our business is open Monday through Saturday. We ask that customers do not contact us about order statuses unless it has been 5 or more business days and you have not received a tracking number, yada, yada, yada. Shipping price changes as of November 1st, 2014. Our shipping and handling price will increase to $6.25 for any order that does not qualify for the free shipping code production. Then he gives his reasoning and for everything about it, which is all well and good. I'm not going to knock a person for the way they do business because, let's face it, Dr. Crimmy's product speaks for itself. He never called it a premium juice, and I'm sure his sales have been astronomical because the man makes a good juice. But the ship, raising the to $75 for your free shipping. Now, let me explain my reasoning. A lot of people are going to say, oh, well, it's only another $15. True. But you can't spend $15. If you're going to buy a 60 mil bottle, that's $20. Now, why would you buy a 60 mil bottle for $20 when for an additional $10, you can get 120 mils? So basically, in my old whacked out mind, you have to I have to spend $90 now and buy three 120 mil bottles of juice to qualify for free shipping. Okay? Like I said, it's not a knock on the product, but some of the reasoning behind it doesn't make sense to me. But like I said, it's not up to me to tell anyone on this fucking planet how to run their business. In my regular job, there's rules that I don't agree with that I have to enforce. So far, it's this country. It's not the country. It's up to the people. Everybody's got a right to make a dollar. This is a capitalist society. Bottom line. One thing I remember, I mean, if you've seen my videos, you obviously have. I review a lot of Dr. Crimmy's juice. I was there right from the fucking beginning. And I've never gotten any, you know, I'm not asking for anything for free. I'm more than happy to buy my own juice. But it's, like, I never got a, hey, thanks for posting the vid. Anything. Never. Never a link on their site like, oh, look, Uncle Ed did a review of this juice. Oh, you want to know it? Here's what Uncle Ed has said. No recognition whatsoever. Fine. There's 1,000 more popular reviewers out there than me. Probably 10,000. I've got 42 subscribers. But, you know, I'm not at it for the glory. I would like anyone. A thank you once in a blue moon would be fucking just courtesy. You know, you can give away all the little plastic animals you want. I don't know. I'm off on a little tangent. I'm off on a little rant. I'm not going to knock the man's juice. The man makes some good shit. Now you have to wait, in my opinion, for Dr. Crimmys to come around. You got to give it 2 weeks. Minimum for his juice. I was going to place an order this week and buy 2 bottles of juice. But after reading about the increase, I said, you know, I do have some Crimmys left I need to review. I will get them out of the way. Even though I never told him I was going to review them. I don't like whoring myself out. That's why, like, if you subscribe, God, thank you. Thank you. If you told a friend, thank you. Some of the other juice makers out there actually have, like, hey, dude, thanks a lot, man. That's a great review. Bubba. They took the time. I don't mind supporting them. I don't ask for nothing for free. I'll buy it. I'm a consumer just like you are. I'm a vapor just like you are. Do I agree with with my reasoning of now that I have to order 320 mil bottles now to get free shipping? No, I don't. I don't. I'm sorry. If I'm not going to say I'm not going to order. because there's still juice I want to order, but now I'm not going to order, like I almost, pretty much for a while there, I was ordering every week. I was ordering 220 ml bottles. At one time, I had like 11 bottles of Dr. Crimmy's in my cabinet. Now I have, I think, three bottles. I wish him the best of success. I will keep on buying this juice, but I'm not pissed. I'm more disappointed. But I guess that's growing pains with a business. So, Dr. Crimmy, keep up the good work. Once again, I highly recommend this juice. I recommend this root beer float. You're not getting that licorice taste, which I hate. It's a damn good fucking juice. Buy it. I do. You want to buy Dr. Crimmy's? Read my reviews. I got a lot of them. Those are some goddamn good juice. The price for a bottle is fucking excellent. Absolutely excellent. But the free ship code, to me, it's not in existence anymore. Okay? So you're gonna pay the $6.25 for shipping. That's the way I'm gonna word it from now on. From now on, you're gonna get if you buy a bottle of it, still, where are you gonna get a 120 mil bottle for $36.25? You're not. You're not going to find it anywhere. Except Casey Jones Mainline Reserve and some cost you less. But still, 120 mils of premium e juice for $36.25. Think about that compared to some of the other juices I reviewed that are 30 mil bottle for $22. No matter what, it's still a killer fucking deal. All right? Don't let my ravings, my little rant be a knock on Dr. Crimmy's e-juice, because it's not. It's just a personal thing for me. I'm old, I'm on a budget, I'm on a fixed budget. I'm working one day a week, so I have to order less. No problem. Until next time. Get your root beer on. Live long and vapor. Bye, guys.